The Bell 212 Twin Huey, also known as the Twin 212, was a two-blade, twin-engine, medium helicopter that first flew in 1968. Originally manufactured by Bell Helicopter in Fort Worth, Texas, production moved to Mirabelle, Quebec, Canada in 1988, along with all of Bell's commercial helicopter production after the plant opened in 1986. The 212 was marketed to civilian operators and had a 15-seat configuration, with one pilot and 14 passengers. In cargo configuration, the 212 has an internal capacity of 220 cubic feet, 6.23 cubic meters. External loads up to 5,000 pounds, 2,268 kilograms, can be carried. Based on the stretched fuselage of the Bell 205, the Bell 212 was originally developed for the Canadian Forces as the CUH-1N and later redesigned as the CH-135. Canadian troops took delivery of 50 units starting in May 1971. At the same time, the United States Military Service ordered 294 Bell 212s under the designation UH-1N. By 1971, the 212 had been developed for commercial applications. Among the earliest uses of the 212 in civil aviation was by the U.S. Helicopter Service of Norway for use in support of offshore oil rigs. Currently, 212 can be found used in logging, maritime rescue and resupply operations in the Arctic on the FAR Early Warning Line or Northern Warning System. The main rotor of the 212 is powered by a Pratt & Whitney Canada PT6T-3 twin pack consisting of two paired PT6 power turbines driving a common gearbox. They were capable of producing up to 1,800 shp, 1,342 kilowatts. If one engine failed, the remaining engines could develop 900 shp, 671 kilowatts, for 30 minutes. Or 765 shp, 571 kilowatts continuously, allowing the 212 to maintain cruising performance at maximum weight. Early 212s configured with the Instrument Flight Rules IFR instrument package were required to have large, highly visible fins mounted on the roof of the aircraft, above and slightly behind the cockpit. These fins were originally thought to be necessary to modify the aircraft's turning performance during complex instrument flight maneuvers, but are now unnecessary due to revised type certificate provisions. Many aircraft are still flying with modifications. In 1979, with the purchase of 8 units by the Civil Air Authority, the 212 became the first U.S. helicopter sold in the PRC. The ICAO designation for this aircraft is used in the flight plan as B212. Bell further developed the Model 212 with the Bell 412. The main difference is the 4-blade composite main rotor. The last Bell 212 was delivered in 1998. Bell 212, also known as the Twin Huey, the medium-lift helicopter is a two-engine version of the Bell Model 205 UH-1H. Originally developed for the Canadian Forces as the Bell Model 212, the UH-1N is powered by the Pratt & Whitney T-400 CP-400 military designation for the commercial PT-63-inch twin-pack, consisting of two turboshaft PT-6 engines mated to a combined gearbox to drive single-output shaft to the helicopter's main transmission. The combined units can produce a maximum of 1,800 axle horsepower. If one engine dies, the remaining engines can operate at 900 shaft horsepower for 30 minutes. The T-400 was relegated to its main transmission limit of 1,290 axle horsepower. The helicopter has other improvements over the Model 205-01DH Huey. The main rotor blades have a wider cord, providing more lift. The main transmission is rated for the greater power input. The tail boom and tail rotor mast were reinforced, and the tail rotor was moved to the opposite side of the mast, in a tractor configuration instead of the former pusher configuration. The rotation of the tail rotor blades is reversed, with the advanced blades moving upwards to the main rotor's underflow, making it more efficient. The visual differences are a streamlined nose and a reshaped doghouse covering the twin engine installation. The U.S. Air Force normally operates the UH-1N with two pilots and a flight engineer, but can be flown by one pilot in visual weather conditions. If necessary, it is capable of carrying up to 12 passengers in addition to a crew of three. Bell Helicopter Company. The UH-1N Iroquois, Model 212, was 57 feet, 3 inches, 17,450 meters, long, with a main rotor diameter of 48 feet, 0 inches, 14,630 meters, and a tail rotor diameter of 8 feet, 6 inches, 2,591 meters. The overall height of the helicopter is 12 feet, 10 inches, 3,912 meters, and the fuselage has a maximum width of 9 feet, 5 inches, 2,870 meters. The helicopter's empty weight is 6,032 pounds, 2,736 kilograms depending on equipment installed. Maximum takeoff weight is 10,500 pounds, 4,763 kilograms. The Pratt & Whitney Canada T400 CP400 has a maximum continuous power rating of 1,530 shaft horsepower at 6,600 revolutions per minute at sea level. The helicopter's cruising speed is 110 knots, 127 miles per hour, 204 kilometers per hour, and a maximum speed of 128 knots, 147 miles per hour, 237 kilometers per hour, at sea level. The UH-1N has an out-of-ground effect hover ceiling, HOG, of 13,000 feet, 3,962 meters. The service ceiling is 21,600 feet, 6,584 meters. The combat radius is 105 nautical miles, 121 legal miles, 194 kilometers. The maximum ferry range is 565 nautical miles, 650 legal miles, 1,046 kilometers. The UH-1N can be armed with a .50 caliber GAU 16 machine gun or a 7.62 mm GAU 17 inches minigun. The UH-1N is operated by the Air Force, U.S. Navy and Marine Corps, as well as many foreign military services. In civilian use, the Bell 212 is the most common medium transport helicopter worldwide and has been in use for 45 years. Of the 79 UH-1N helicopters ordered by the U.S. Air Force in 1968, 59 are still in active service as of September 2015. On September 24, 2018, the U.S. Air Force announced it would be replacing its UH-1N fleet with 84 Boeing Leonardo MH-139s, with the first aircraft delivered in 2021.